Now, you all know about this new interest in mindfulness, using, again, a lot is using the breathing exercises, using the Mavalian vagus from the orbital frontal, helping you to begin to be able to control this somatic body of yours that's getting out of tune and does not. So you learn to do that through various ways. There are many different approaches. Meditation is a very similar journey. Different people suits different methods. And yoga is very, yoga, not just the physical exercise yoga, but that particular aspect of yoga. And many people swear by it. And many very disturbed people who have now done, they really value this approach enormously. Some simply just use that. So if you have a patient in this, it's wise to encourage them, but to go to the right kind of person, to go and do that at the same time as they're having therapy, if they can afford it. Fortunately, these things are not very expensive. Dialectical behavior therapy was invented some time ago, and it's used for in the treatment of borderline patients, people with that diagnosis. It is a very useful, it gives you ways of dealing with different things that might happen in your life. What to do when you are losing your temper, what to do when you are faced with a day where you just don't, you know, you feel so depressed, you don't want to get up, and so on. It has different things, and it is run in groups, and people on programs for borderline personality disorder diagnosis, they go through a whole training of DBT. And it does reduce symptoms, and it does give people a sense of being in control. Remember, control is so important for people who feel out of control and helpless. But for some people, they consider that that's it. That's all somebody needs. But actually, it doesn't cure the borderline, and I believe you can go beyond. But that is what many institutions, they just offer that. And that already is halfway there.